Okay, back here for round three of astronomy for g is equals eta to 8. We're going to dive into the greatest astronomer of all time, the man who built the Leviathan, the 72-inch telescope, the largest. He was basically a modern-day Noah, building this huge thing in his backyard to the glory of g is equals eta to 8. First of all, his name, 181, three-digital factor 8 number with 8 at dead center. More details on his title. He was born in 1800. He lived exactly 67 years. Boils down to 8 exactly by the law of prime. One of his sons invented the steam turbine. Another was a reverend. Totally loaded man. This is what he built. Totally awesome. And now I'm going to dive into a universal concept for this whole... This thing is called the Leviathan. And... you go to the root of words to see the extra juice. This is a universal concept that I'm going to explain right now that is universal in this whole study of finding the glory of Jesus equals 8 to 8 in all of history, in all the universe, in all the words that he has ordained to be in all of history. All languages have a root, and the deepest root of all is Hebrew. Hebrew is the original of originals, that which was spoken in the Garden of Eden by God and Adam and Eve themselves. The Holy Ghost uses all languages to glorify Jesus equals 8 to 8. And the deeper you go, the more juicy the numbers are. You always go to the root as much as possible to get the greatest juice. Even nature itself tells you that. Everyone wants to be, you know, whatever is closest to the root gets the most juice. It's that simple. And even in mining, you know, there's that term called the mother lode. You know, the gold miners, they want to trace those few flecks of gold back up to the source. That is the mother lode, the center. Always, you want to get to the root. Root in equals 800 exactly. Root in Latin, radix, equals 56 exactly. I'll show you this right now, just how fast this is. Spell it right here. Radix, you can see how fast it can work. Radix equals... 56, bang on the nose. And that equals root in Latin. The word Latin itself is the same thing. 56, perfect sevenfold set of eights. Boom, root. That's the word for root. This word radix is used all over the place to this day. It defines literally the basis of any numbering system. Radix 8, radix 10, decimal means radix 10, and it's used all over the place. I encourage you to read the Wikipedia article on radix to see how prolific this word is. Well, it's Latin for root. Latin is the root of nearly all the European languages, including English. So English is up here on the tree. Latin is the root, okay? French is another derivative. You know, Dutch, Spanish, they're all derivatives from Latin root. So Latin has the juiciest gems for G's equals 8 at 8. And the Holy Ghost said to me, gaze upon the cross and you shall have all wisdom. What was the sign written over Jesus' head on the cross? It was written in Hebrew and in Greek and in Latin. Why? Because those are the three rootmost languages that God has ordained for the greatest gold in this mathematical study of the glory of Jesus equals 8 to 8 in all the universe and in all of world history. Hebrew is the deepest. Greek is the next. And then Latin is the next on top of that. But all three of them have their own astonishing abundant glories to the glory of Jesus equals 8 to 8, which is the crown jewel of the whole story of the universe. English is one of the thickest branches, though, on this tree of Latin, because the British Empire was the Davidic Empire. David was the eighth of eight sons, and God swore to David that your kingdom shall last forever. And that is the British monarchy. To this day, the Queen of England is of the seed of David, and that is by divine ordinance, the fulfillment of God's sworn promise that David's throne would last forever. And that is the British monarchy. It has been the largest empire on earth, and the current monarch, the Queen, currently reigns over 53 Commonwealth nations. It is still the largest empire on earth, and English is the official language of it. That's why the English language has prospered to the extent that it has. All things are by divine ordinance, the glory of Jesus equals 8 to 8. Hallelujah. Who is the root and offspring of David. Amen. But the reason I share these facts at this time is because it's so important that when you find, you know, when you're looking at a story of God in the history of the world And you find something so prominent as this, as the telescope, the greatest telescope ever made by a man who ended up discovering the first whirlpool, the first spiral galaxy called the Whirlpool, which is 128 by divine ordinance. This telescope is 72 inches in diameter, the largest, 72, 3 by 3 grid of 8, the largest in the world by far at that time, and it stayed the largest in the world for exactly 72 years. And then when it was finally no longer the largest, the one that replaced it was the telescope called Hooker, which equals 72 exactly. I can add that up before your very eyes right now, just this fast. Hooker, ready? Double click, multiply, boom, 72, 3 by 3 grid of 8s. That is the name of the telescope that replaced this 72-inch telescope, which by divine ordinance was the largest in the world for 72 years. So, a 72-inch telescope that stays the largest in the world for 72 years and is then replaced by a telescope that adds to 72 perfectly, it's just the creativity of God to glorify His Son, Jesus, equals 8 to 8 in all things. Amen. Now, this telescope had a name. It was called Leviathan. Well, Leviathan does not divide by 8 in English as satisfyingly as we would hope it would. Well, why is that? Because the root of that word in Leviathan is from Hebrew. So, this is a universal concept that you just need to get in the whole story of God to glorify Jesus mathematically. Hebrew is the most important. It's the deepest. Okay, so when you read a word up here in English that is up here on the tree, as we are doing right now, we're reading that this large telescope was called Leviathan. Well, you say, where does that word come from? We're up here on the tree in English. Where does that word Leviathan come from? You go to the root. It's called, the scientific term for it is called etymology. It means tracing the origin of words. Where did they come from? You have to go to the root to get the most gold, to see the most glory of Jesus. So the word Leviathan comes, comes from the Hebrew word. We're just going to pull it up here directly from the scripture. Right here. Ready to do the math on it? Aha! There we have the glory. See that? So we just did exactly this. We read the word Leviathan up here in English, okay? And then we traced it to its roots in Hebrew, down here where the gold lies, okay? And then we did the calculation on the root, and perfectly, yes, Leviathan in Hebrew, God's holy language, adds to 496, which divides by 8 perfectly. And furthermore, is a double of 8 multiplied by what is called a unitary prime, 31 deduces to 1 by the law of prime, and so all shining stardom is on what is doubled, namely Mr. 8. Hallelujah. So that's Leviathan. And God, in Job chapter 41, brags about Leviathan for an entire chapter, saying how epic this creature is. Wow. And so this is a big word. And so when now we come to another God story several centuries later, of the greatest astronomer who ever lived, who built a telescope called Leviathan, well, is God going to pass up the opportunity to take the glory for Jesus equals 8 to 8 for the name of this telescope? Absolutely not. But the key to you finding the juice, to finding the glory, is not to calculate the name of this telescope in English, but to go to the root of that word Leviathan, which is in Hebrew. So, this is a universal concept. A universal concept. Oftentimes, when you are reading a story of God in history, just pick anything in history you want, and you come across something that's very prominent, you know, a word that is very prominent in the story that you think should would make sense to glorify Jesus mathematically exceedingly as a gem. If it does not, try going to the root of the word. It's called etymology. Trace the word to its root. Chances are it might be a derivative of Hebrew, or it might be a derivative of Greek, or it might be a derivative of Latin. And the Holy Ghost said to me, gaze upon the cross, and you shall have all wisdom and knowledge. Well, the sign over Jesus' head on the cross was written in Hebrew and in Greek and in Latin. Why? Because those are the root languages that God ordained to have the most gold in them for the mathematical glory of Jesus. So if you're ever reading, you know, a story with a key English word that isn't as juicy as you would expect it to be or hope it to be, I try digging deeper. Try checking the Latin word for the Latin root, or the Greek, or the Hebrew, because those are the root level languages. Amen. And as we said before, the word root in Latin is radix, which equals 56, and the word Latin equals 56. Using totally different letters, that's what you have to marvel. Okay? These words use totally different letters, but they add to the same number. That's the mind of God. This is 12, then 1, then 20, then 9, then 14. This is 18, 1, 4, 9, 24. Okay? And so, the word root in Latin, radix, is 56. And the word root in Hebrew is even better, it's 800. Shoresh, the root. Hallelujah. Jesus is the root of everything. Hallelujah. But that is a universal concept. And here's the best website for you to find the roots of words. Etymology Online. Right here. This is your best friend for accomplishing this universal fact. Boom. Come here. If there's a word in English that you would like to know the roots of it, just plug it in right here, just like a Google search. And you will get the depth of it in here. So a fascinating one. God has to take the glory for sex. Jesus created sex. First of all, sex is 48. Bang on the nose. Boom. And it starts with 24, 888. And it finishes with X, 888, 24. It also starts with S, which is an eighth prime, 8. And it finishes with X, which is 24, 888. In every way, God has made sure that Jesus, the creator of sex, takes the glory for sex in the word mathematically. So every time it's spoken, every time it's read, every time it's written, Jesus equals 888, the creator of sex, takes the glory for it. And even better, sex in Latin adds 40 to that to bring the grand total to 88 exactly. So let's do a search. We're going to the root of this word to find it. And you will find the Latin right here, sexus, 88. See that? So God has increased the glory here. We're harvesting the entire branch of the tree, or the entire gold vein. Another good image for you to have is the image of, pardon me, I spelled that quickly, is the image of a gold vein, where you see a flake of gold at the surface, but you want to scoop out the entire vein. That is, you want to get to the root, the taproot, the mother lode, as it were. Just like a tree, you know, you're up here at the branch, well, you want to harvest the whole, you want to go all the way down the root to get all the juice, okay? That's what we're doing here. So, the word sex in English equals 48 exactly. Then, the Latin, which is deeper, okay? The Latin is sexus, which adds perfectly 40 to make the total 88 exactly. Wow. And even better, or just as good, another good friend of yours is Google Translate. Let's check the Greek on this. Right here. Ready? 1,000. Bang on the nose. All factor 8 number that divides by 8 perfectly. So let's get this straight. Sex in English, 48. Sex in Latin, 88. I'm just going to do this so you can follow my workflow here. Right here. 88. And then in Greek, 1,000. So, let's be clear on who created sex so we can educate our children properly. Folks, sex education in school systems without Jesus is phony baloney. And it's retarded ballarded. And it's whatever kind of stupid word you want to make up for the nonsensibility of it all. If you don't teach the children Jesus, and you don't introduce them to Jesus, the whole thing is hopeless. Don't even start trying to teach them about things if you don't give them Jesus, because Jesus is the one that gives people power over sin and over temptation and over every single piece of bunk garbage that comes their way their whole lives long. So if you don't give them Jesus, you don't give them power over sin. It's that simple. And if they don't understand that Jesus is the creator of sex, then they are not going to experience the highest level of blessing and pleasure and glory that God is capable of giving them as husband and wife, married by God, ordained by God to be husband and wife in all properness and dignity. And my goodness, if you get two people filled with the Holy Ghost, falling in love, righteously filled with Jesus, in love with Jesus, and it's pleasure heaven like you wouldn't believe. Because Jesus is the creator of sex. And if you're close to the creator, then it's going to be blessed. And it's going to be 100% pure, 100% blessed, 100% natural, 100% full of love, 100% like God himself is going to be like watching over you just like he did Adam and Eve at the beginning. And it's going to be, believe me, it's going to be better than anything you could possibly imagine. Far better than anything. So in review, you are getting the best instruction right now that you could possibly get about sex, namely the mathematical proof that Jesus created it. Because if you had understood that when you were in grade 3 or grade 4, which is what children need to understand, then you understand that it's a holy thing. You understand that Jesus is the source of blessing for it. And aside from the actual, sexual intercourse, this word sex is also used just to describe the sex of male and female. You know, even in the entire species kingdom, you know, of the sexes, even the plural of this adds another 24 to the whole thing. So get this straight. This in every way, it's over the top. SE is 24, 888. Then you've got the X at the middle, 24, 888. And then you've got another SE at the end, 888. And it's perfectly mirrored. And by divine ordinance, God created two sexes. So that when you use this plural word, sexes, whether it's talking about mankind made in God's image or all the creatures which God ordains to have sex and be the two sexes, Jesus equals 888 is the maker of it all. So we need to teach our children this. Your children need to know. Your daughter needs to know. When your daughter is 15 years old, when she's 8 years old, she can do this math when she's 8 years old or younger. I think I was 5 years old when I was doing arithmetic, just by the grace of God. Sex equals 48 in English, okay? I'm just going to write these out here to save time. Sex is in Latin, is 88 exactly, and then sex in Greek is 1,000 exactly, right here. So, in every way, Jesus has you cornered. Jesus owns sex. Jesus created sex. Sex is a holy thing. And you need to seek Jesus. If you give your life to Jesus, believe me, he will take care of all your needs. He'll provide your spouse in the perfect time. You need to focus on Jesus. And if it's his will that you get married, he will bring your spouse your way. If you worship Jesus, serve the glory of the name of Jesus, he will take care of every other part of your life. That's the truth. Okay. So, I just use that as an example of this fabulous website called Etymology Online. Etymology is a creepy, nonsensical word. Well, I guess there's some sense in it, to basically describe going to the root of the matter. We say this very plainly in English by saying, I want to get to the bottom of this. I want to get to the root of the matter. I want to get to the center. I want to get to the heart of the issue. I want to get to the bottom of this, the root. Take me to the root and I'll be satisfied. It's a universal principle that I'll state right now. The closer you are to the root of anything in this universe, the more satisfied you will be. And of course, the closer you are to God, who is the root of all things, that's the ultimate satisfaction. Okay, so this is going to the root of words. So if you find a prominent word in the story of God in English, try typing it in here and see what you find in Latin or in Greek or in Hebrew. And chances are, if you didn't see the eights in the word up here in English, chances are you will see it down here in Latin or in Greek or in Hebrew. Hallelujah. For example, the word love in Hebrew, which is the deepest of all, okay? The word love is spelled and spoken in many different languages and many different ways all over the world. God uses all languages to glorify His Son mathematically. That is the ultimate truth. But the root languages are the juiciest, okay? So, Hebrew is the original, pure, holy language of God that was spoken in the Garden of Eden. Well, how do you spell love in Hebrew? Let's do it right now, just see for your own satisfaction. Love to Hebrew, right here. It's amazing the stuff you have to weed through in order to get to the juice. The root of the word love is this three glyphs right here. Ahav. I'm trying to highlight it so you can hear that sound effect. Oh, Google. Really? Just allow me. There we go. So there you go. Love equals 8 exactly. Love equals 8 exactly. That is the root, okay? That is the deepest you can go with respect to that word love. You want to know the definition of love? Love equals 8, okay? Hebrew. Hebrew, the deepest of the deep. That's down here. That's like the central taproot of this tree, okay? If this is a tree that has all the different, you know, words for love, that God has, all of them are ordained for, you know, different combinations for mathematical glory for Jesus, you know, in all the languages of the earth, but the ultimate, central, one and only, original, deep taproot for love is Hebrew, which equals 8 exactly. So now you're satisfied because you've gotten to the deepest root possible of the matter. In Hebrew, love equals 8 exactly. Ah, now you take a deep breath of element 8 to stay alive, and you are satisfied because you have now found the mind of God. The deepest, at the deepest level, okay? Love equals 8 exactly. The two greatest commandments. Love equals 8. Now, can you imagine how valuable this would be for every single person in the world to understand these facts from their youth? That every single young person would understand that love equals 8 exactly, and that they're breathing element 8 to stay alive. So, for example, here is a bunch of Harvard students that have the number 8 on their front. H is 8. So they're all wearing the number 8. Harvard, by divine ordinance, adds to 72 exactly, a perfect 3 by 3 grid of 8s. How valuable do you think it would be for her and 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 him and him and him and him and him and all of these people to know that love equals 8, that they're breathing element 8 to stay alive, that they have 8 bones on their face, that they have 16 teeth on the top, 16 teeth on the bottom, double 8, double 8, they have 24 bones up their spine in 3 segments of 8, triple 8, 888. And we've solved human anatomy multiple times over, 240 bones in all their bodies, 120 in their limbs, the other 120 in their cores, all 3-digit olfactory 8 numbers that divide by 8 perfectly. And for how valuable would it be for all these people to know all of these things, and most of all, understand that love equals 8, and that they're all breathing element 8 to stay alive? How valuable do you think it would be for all these people to understand that? And then for all of these people to understand that? And then for every single person in the universe to understand that? Personally, I declare that it would be the most valuable thing that has ever been understood by mankind in the history of the universe. Because if every single one of these people understood the mind of God, that love equals 8 exactly, and that they're all breathing element 8 to stay alive, and that Jesus equals 8 at 8, we would bring heaven down to earth in as close a way as it possibly could. Why? Because God says the understanding of a man changes him. Truth. Jesus said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. If you are baptized in the truth as a child, it literally is a substance that fills you with a totally new persona, and you are full of love your whole life long. These people that are all so-called graduating from Harvard, which equals 72, these people don't know that love equals 8 exactly. And they don't know that they probably all know that they're breathing element 8 to stay alive, but they don't know that Jesus equals 8 at 8. They don't know that Lord equals 800. They don't know that King equals 848. They don't know that love equals 8 exactly. They don't know that faith equals 800 exactly in Greek. They don't know 1/1000th of all the treasure of God mathematically, that everything is for Jesus equals 8 at 8. They probably don't even know that they have 8 bones on their faces. I venture that less than 1% of the faces in this crowd understand that they have 8 bones on their faces by the creation of Jesus equals 8 at 8, and that love equals 8 exactly, and that they are called first and foremost to live a life of love for God. I venture that less than 1% of these people understand that, and that is a tremendous tragedy, and it needs to change with as much money and manpower as we can throw at this. Okay? Here's the Harvard logo. It's a giant 8. Here's the Harvard name. Adds to 72 perfectly. Its original motto was that every student's aim is to know Christ and to understand that Christ is the foundation of all learning. Well, that's what it needs to be all over the world. In eightfold measure. That is to say, everyone understands that Jesus Christ is God. Okay? Hallelujah. So praise God for the Holy Ghost who guides you into all truth. I received none of these things from a university. I received all of these things from the Holy Ghost, who gives a better education than all the universities in the world combined. Such is the way of God. He gives freely to those who seek Him. It will cost you no money. You don't need to pay any tuition. You don't need to go in debt. You don't need to, you know, pay some crazy tuition amount to get the best education in the world. You only need the Holy Ghost and a lot of prayer. And God will give you the very best of everything, free of charge. Hallelujah. That's the way of God. That's how generous He is, and patient He is, and willing He is to teach the one who is willing to listen. Okay. So, universal concept. Get to the root of everything. Always go to the root. When you read a story, go to the root. So, now you see the glory of Jesus in this great story here. The root of astronomy, essentially. Hallelujah. And there I excitedly documented that Leviathan indeed divides by 8 in Hebrew. That's the name of the greatest telescope ever constructed for astronomy in the history of the world, because this was done by practically one man single-handedly. Hallelujah. And God is not impressed. God is not nearly as impressed as what a large group of men do half-heartedly as He is with what one man does with all his heart. I dare say that God would rather see one man going all out to the extreme than 100 men going half-hearted to build something that's just, you know, a bunch of large bricks. Nice big building built by a bunch of people that were working half-heartedly. God would much rather see one man carve a masterpiece going all out. That's the way God is. Quality. He wants to see people who are going all out. Okay. So, by the way, the man who built this telescope was so blessed that he had 13 children. And I encourage you to read everything else about his life. Look at how cool it is. His the largest telescope was the 72 one at the end here. Look at, this is an actual photograph of it. Can you imagine? This thing is like, look, I mean, these are real life steps here. So this thing is like about 4 stories tall, maybe. 3 to 4 stories tall. It looks like there's a man standing on it right there. When was the last time you walked by, you know, a neighbor's yard and saw someone doing something cool like this? I tell you, it won't happen in a godless education society. You will not see this. In a society with godless education, you will not see this kind of epic endeavor. I'll tell you what you will see in a godless society. I'll tell you exactly what you will see. you will see this. A bunch of tiny little screens with tiny little soundtracks that are produced in roughly, you know, a week's time. This is what you will see. You will see a bunch of cheap consumer trinketry that is hardly epic in the slightest degree. That's all you will see in a godless society. There's a bunch of people droning out to simple music. You will not see epic endeavor like this. You will not see great endeavor like this in your neighborhood. You will not see it. You'll see a bunch of just followers. You'll see a bunch of followers. That's ultimately you will see. The person who created the iPod, that's kind of cool. But I mean, really, it's kind of cheesy as well. This is cool. This is epic. This is some guy saying, I'm going all out here. And I want to see the glory of God. And I'm going to build this thing in the year 1850 because I can and I will. Given, by all estimations, folks, given the manpower that we have today, this is pretty shameful that this is the greatest thing, you know, that people are giving their lives to. Okay. So, look at it. Here's a larger picture of it. The guy wanted to see the glory of God, and see the glory of God he did, and he's remembered as the father of all astronomy, practically. Oh, just huge. And then even in English, it's glorious. Oh, yeah. Sorry, this is 92, so the Leviathan telescope is 192. Watch this. Leviathan telescope, it's called in English. Boom, boom, boom. 8 times 888, 8 times 24. And that's bringing us to a temporary wrap-up on astronomy. Oh my gosh, and this is a huge gem here. Let's close on this one. As of today, well, actually, as of 1922, probably before you were born, the International Astronomical Union adopted the modern list of 88 constellations. That is to say, the entire universe has now been mapped into 88 regions into which every single celestial body falls. And that is the way that it will be. It will not be added to or subtracted to until Jesus returns. 88 to the glory of Jesus equals 888. And look at this, folks. Who drew up the precise boundaries for each of these constellations so that every point in the sky now belongs to exactly one of these 88 zones to the glory of Jesus equals 888? Eugene Joseph Delporte. Okay. His first name, Eugene, is 57, 888 by the law of prime. The whole thing adds to 220, a three-digit all-factor 8 number. And then just his first name and last name, which is most commonly spoken, is 8 times the 8th prime. So in every way, Jesus equals 888 has this one cornered. And you can go to the website 88 Constellations here to see the full list of the 88 constellations. And you can poke into each of them to see the details on them. But it is, folks, it is 88 constellations, not 87, not 80, you know, 86 or, you know, 93 or something like that. No, it's 88, folks. By divine ordinance, the glory of Jesus equals 88. And you can see the history of it. It's been that way since 1922, and it will be that way until Jesus Christ returns. And you can see that it is Mr. Eugene Delporte. Now this is not calculating correctly because I don't have it adapted for the accents, but E is E. Eugene Delporte, 8 times the 8th prime, originally listed the 88 modern constellations on behalf of the International Astronomical Union. There you go, in 1930. So, over 80 years ago, the 88 constellations, constellational regions of the universe were defined once and for all time, and that was done by Mr. 8 times the 8th prime himself. There you go. Glory to Jesus Christ. And as a fun little finish, the reason that I play this, the one-up sound effect from Mario every time we find a gem for Jesus equals 8 at 8, is because by divine ordinance, that sound effect is exactly the six letters that match the six letters of creation and the six letters of Jesus' name. And it is the sound effect for none other than an extra life, that is to say, for resurrection. The extra life. God is the most creative person in the universe, folks. He is also the most joyful person in the universe. He is also the most fun person in the universe. And the one-up sound effect is the most famous sound effect in all of interactive entertainment. And Mario adds perfectly to 56, a sevenfold set of eights, just for your confirmation. But what is the one-up? It's extra life. That is resurrection. That means you get to come back to life. Well, that's what Jesus gives, okay? And the six notes of this sound effect, the most famous sound effect in all the video games, which I'll play again for you right now when you get one of these one-ups. We'll play it again right now on Eugene Delport. Those six notes, dun-dun-dun, dun-dun-dun, perfectly match the six letters of Jesus equals 8 at 8. And they perfectly match the 6 days of creation, which is to say the first note pairs with the fourth note, and the second pairs with the fifth, and the third pairs with the sixth. The notes of the one-up sound effect are C, D, G. You can play this on the piano, folks. I believe it's C, D, G, C, D, E. Only the last, so the first pairs with the fourth, the second pairs with the fifth, and the third pairs with the sixth. Just like the six letters of Jesus' name that make Jesus equals 8 at 8, and just like the 6 days of creation. Day 1 pairs with day 4, day 2 pairs with day 5, and day 3 pairs with day 6. And the same thing is done with the six letters of Jesus' name in Greek, which equals 8 at 8. So it's a divinely orchestrated sound effect. So whenever you hear that play, dun dun dun, dun dun dun. It might be C, D, E, C, D, G. Let's listen again. Yeah. It finishes on the high note. See that? Listen to it carefully. It's a divinely orchestrated sound effect. It's the most pleasing sound effect you can possibly listen to. It's the sound effect for life itself. Everyone who has ever played any video game recognizes that sound effect. And it was by far the most pleasing sound effect to ever achieve in a video game. Well, by divine ordinance, it perfectly matches the six letters of Jesus' name in Greek. The six notes perfectly match the six letters of Jesus equals 8 at 8. And what does it mean? Life. Life. Resurrection. Jesus is the resurrection and the life. God is the funnest person. God ordained Mario and the one-up sound effect for his own mathematical glory. Mario is the original and the quintessential video game character. Mario equals 56. Watch, let's do the math on Mario right now. Mario, the most famous video game character. Ready? What is Mario? Let's do the math right now. A perfect sevenfold set of eights. Seven is the number of a set of like things. Eight is the shining star. Mario. Okay, so superhero Mario, that always conquers the world successfully in all of his video games and is the most well-known video game character of all time, the best-selling video game franchise for all time, every single where Mario appears, it brings glory to Jesus equals 8 at 8. Mario, Super Mario, the unstoppable hero that always conquers the world and saves the day, well, he has one number, 56. Perfect sevenfold set of eights. By divine ordinance, the glory of Jesus equals 8 at 8. So there you go. There's a fun one to end on. And we have just traveled through the entire universe. And we continue to travel through the entire story of God in all of its glories for the glory of Jesus equals 8 at 8. Oh, I missed one of the biggest ones. Well, actually, I didn't miss it. I recorded it previously on an epic recording that got lost in this crashing software here. But I don't want to miss this one. One of my favorite words, and one of God's favorite words, is the word lagoon. which is 64, 8 times 8 exactly. And when you consider how paradisical these things are in all the earth, they are like the quintessential honeymoon paradise scene in all the earth. It's basically the vision of paradise, which is a sanctuary. Paradise is an enclosure, friends. It's something that is enclosed. It's a safe place. It's a haven, a place of rest where you feel protected, where you feel safe. That's why every sanctuary, Eden itself, is a garden enclosed. Well, a lagoon is an enclosure of water. But every single lagoon, everywhere that word appears, every single lagoon, every travel brochure, every single tourist advertisement, every single map, you know, here we see a map with the word lagoon on it, but lagoon resort here, and here is, it's called a lagoon. You see it written here, lagoon. Well, lagoon equals 8 times 8. So every single lagoon on earth is owned by Jesus. He takes the glory for every single lagoon all over the world. And the Lagoon Nebula is one of the most beautiful nebulas in the universe. And there's this great video on YouTube here where it does, where you dive into the Lagoon Nebula. And it's just absolutely breathtaking and astonishing beyond reason. Do you see how mankind has always desired to, go to the center of things? It's just an innate desire in you, made in God's image. You want to go to the center. You want to get to the root of everything. Well, who's at the center of everything? God. Well, in order to know God, you must know Jesus Christ. And you must believe in Jesus Christ as the Son of God and the literal creator of the universe, the Bible says, in order to have a relationship with God. Hallelujah. So, there's another one for you. The word lagoon. 8 times 8, exactly. Wow. Oh, yeah. And this fellow here. Just amazing. This is such a huge gem. This fellow here, I encourage you to read all about him. His name adds to 248. He was born on the 16th day of the 8th month of the year 1744. Every single number divides by 8, and his life was ordained by God in astronomy. And he did a number of epic things and made a number of great discoveries, and I encourage you to read from his life. In fact, I have his YouTube biography open here. Just let me pull it up. Oh yeah, here's a picture of the pair, the brother and the sister. This guy is 236, she is 244. They're exactly, he's 4 less than 240, she's 4 more than 240. The brother and sister, they differ by 8 exactly by divine ordinance. Together they make 480 in 48 letters exactly, their full names. She was a midget. She was not expected to do anything great with her life. And now she is one of the most historic names in astronomy, because her and her brother, this was a full-grown man. She was only 4 feet 3 inches, but she worked in astronomy alongside her brother, and they have gone down in history as two of the greatest original astronomers of all time, and named many of God's artworks in the sky for the mathematical glory of Jesus by divine ordinance. So a total God story. Meek and mild woman, together with her brother, divine for the glory of Jesus equals 8 to 8, to do what they did. The Herschels, read all about them on Wikipedia. We'll close down all of our lagoon images. Lagoon equaling 8 times 8. Here's the man whose name equals 248. Oh my goodness. This guy was one of the pioneers in the study of the universe. You can read all about his life, what he did. He discovered a number of Messier objects, which is huge. Huge in the mind of God. When you consider that God esteems the one who beholds his glory even more highly than the one who, is ambitious in his own, for his own self. For certain, God has says that over and over in the scripture. Over and over, God says he desires the one who seeks him and loves him much more than the one who is working for the praises of men or whatever else you can work for in this world. Seek God. That's the most important thing. All of these things are called NGC number. That is to say, 888-24, and then a number, okay? And then Messier is 88 exactly. And so, though many of them don't even have a common or English name, they all are recognized by number because numbers are king, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. And this man's life, this in full text, this equals 248 exactly. He was born on the 16th, 88 of the 8th month, August, in a year that divides by 8. So his life is a total God story. He was ordained to be an astronomer. He was ordained to see the glory of God in the universe. And I encourage you to read more juicy details in how much of a genius he was. And just the Whirlpool Galaxy, the most famous galaxy in the skies. It was the first named galaxy that is a spiral. It was the first discovered spiral, and it was discovered by Mr. 72-inch telescope himself, Earl of Ross. And look at how beautiful it is. But Whirlpool equals 128. And of course, Messier equals 88. I like to have the numbers showing when you see that. Encyclopedia divides by 8 perfectly, 112. Jesus takes the glory for every encyclopedia in the earth. Awesome. This is the woman, the astronomer with her brother. She was blessed to live 97 years. That is a gift. And she received a gold medal from the Royal Astronomical Society, and she also received a gold medal from the King of Prussia. There is no hope of a godless country receiving those kind of honors, because there is no hope for people to work epically apart from Jesus Christ. William Tyndale, the greatest man who ever lived in biblical scholarship, who essentially wrote almost the entire King James Version single-handedly, because all scholars recognize that today's King James Version is actually 83% Tyndale's work in the New Testament and 76% Tyndale's writing in the Old Testament. One man, single-handedly. This guy could speak 8 languages fluently. This was in the year 1500, before YouTube and electronic education and DVDs and language teaching, you know, tools even existed. This guy was fluent in 8 languages by divine ordinance. William Tyndale's 160 exactly. That's 8 doubled times by 10. Whatever is doubled highlights this guy over here, and then multiplied by 10, same thing. So all shining stardom is on number 8. William Tyndale, hero of heroes, gave us the English Bible almost single-handedly, practically. His predecessor was John Wycliffe, for your confirmation, whose name divides by 8 perfectly. John Wycliffe, are you ready for it? Boom. He was the predecessor. This is dating back to the year 1300 now. Read his entire life and what he stood for, because it's the truth. And you are to look at this number 8 times 17 as an 8 in the dead center, with 8 8s to the left and 8 8s to the right. 17 8s. 17 is an all-factor 7 number, which is the 7th prime. You are to see the number 7 in this. And that 7 is the number of a set of like things, which serves to glorify this guy over here, number 8. And so that is the glory of his name. Both John Wycliffe and William Tyndale, you must name your children to the highest level of mathematical glory for G's equals 8 at 8 if they are to be historic at the highest level possible. That is, to have names that go down in history for the glory of Jesus. Mr. Wycliffe, commemorated here at the centerpiece of the names regarding the Holy Bible given to us in English, right there for all eternity. And to the glory of Jesus equals 8 at 8. So we continue to travel through all of history in every conceivable way imaginable, harvesting the whole thing for Jesus equals 8 at 8. And I'd like to close this universal theme with one of the most famous songs ever written about anything related to the universe. And it is a song by Mr. John Williams, the greatest composer in modern history, and by divine ordinance, let's do it right now. John Williams, I'm not going to spoil it, for you what the number of his name is until we pull it up on Wikipedia here. Are you ready to calculate John Williams for the glory of Jesus equals 888? The great film score composer. Are you ready? In one click, let's do it. Boom. 240, bang on the nose. John Williams, 888 × 10. And we are going to finish this universal discussion with the playing of the greatest of his compositions for all time. It is man's call to see the glory of God in all the universe.